And the main event match between Sammy and Chad Gable, where Chad Gable finally turns heel. What were some of your quick thoughts on Monday Night Raw there, Kev?
Well, Chad Gable turn, I thought was kind of weak. Like, yes, they could have done that a little bit better. I thought it was, everyone thought it was kind of cool that he, you know, gave him a, you know, a back suplex in front of his wife and stuff. It's funny when you're first seeing that and you watch it before you see that it's Chad Gable. It looks like somebody jumped the rail and was like grabbing Sami Zayne.
Yeah, all you saw were little hands.
Yeah, like little hands. I was like, oh my God, someone touching Sami, they're going to put this on camera. And then you realize it's Chad Gable. I thought the turn could have been a lot better. I thought it was obvious too. I was saying that he's going to turn, or maybe they'll just be baby faces that have a, you know, a best of seven series, almost like a throwback to the old days. And
like Kurt and Brock, they're a little back and forth.
Well, they'll both be good guys. You know, the most classic, yeah, Kurt and Brock were the most classic best of seven to me is always Magnum TA and Nikita Koloff back in 85 for the U.S. title. But yeah, I just thought, and Chad Gable is a heel, is still non-threatening. He's a small guy. He's legit, but and Kurt Angle's not a big guy, so I do call him Little Angle. Even his facials and his mannerisms are very Kurt Angle. Maybe it's something of being in the Olympics. I don't know. A lot of these guys are very similar, but he's very Angle-ish. But Angle always seemed like more of a threat. Chad Gable, to me, doesn't seem like a threat to anybody. I just, you know, like him.
He doesn't have the edge. I think Kurt Angle, when you're talking about Kurt Angle and how he was presented, he had an edge to him. There were times that he was silly. Like, he was so magnificent as far as how he could change his persona. Like, you had silly, happy Kurt wearing a stupid hat or shooting milk at people. And then you had ECW roid rage Kurt. Like, he could go from these different parallels, which I don't know if Chad Gable has that in him. Now, I don't think Chad Gable is charismatically challenged at all. I just don't think he's found that edge yet that people are going to believe is a heel. Because even as a heel, Kev, he's been kind of a silly heel for most of the time, like the shoosh stuff and everything. Like,
yeah, thank you and all that stuff.
Right,
and
the stuff that he did with Ezekiel, right? That was all.
Yeah. I mean, yeah, even the catchphrase stuff, it's almost like Chad Gable was searching for something that the crowd could cling on to. You know, when he was with Jason Jordan, American Alpha, they were a good tag team. And obviously the Alpha Academy is an offshoot of that. We all know what happened to Jason Jordan. You know, I was an agent in the back. But yeah, Chad Gable's been around for about 10 years now in this company. And it's always waiting for them to pull the trigger on him. So it's funny when people will talk about whether it's a guy like Cross or someone who's been here 2 years and they still haven't really pulled the trigger up, given that. I look at Chad Gable as a guy that, my God, we're almost a decade in the making of not pulling the full trigger on him. It's giving him props and TV time, and he's a factor to a degree,
right?
But not really a guy who's gonna win again. Always the kind of the lovable loser type of guy,
yeah,
when you think about it. Like, he's a Bad News Bears,
better underdog, absolutely,
yeah, underdog, but still hasn't gotten, I do use words, flowers, but still hasn't gotten to that status yet,
right?
And that, so you know, when someone's saying, oh, 1 or 2 years they're not doing this with this guy, I'm like, look at this dude, 10 years. I mean, how long are they gonna wait? So it's, and you know, then he was that Shorty G for a year, which was a horrible character. So, you know, if he can bounce back from that, anybody can bounce back from a gimmick. That was probably, you know, they turned him into Brian Christopher for 5 minutes. I mean, what was that all about?
He's never been a good heel. I really don't think he's ever been a good heel. I think it's kind of weird, too. If the roles were reversed and Sammy was the heel and Chad was the babyface, I think you can work with something a lot further with his character. Yeah. I think people want to cheer Chad. I think people genuinely like Chad Gable. But you're right, he just hasn't found that niche yet. And I do think that him and Sammy are going to give us tremendous matches. Obviously, Monday was a fantastic match. If you like mat wrestling, if you like technical wrestling and not a lot of flurry high spots and a lot of selling too, Jesus Christ, Sammy was selling both of his legs being broken for most of the match. And then on top of it, the little chunk taken out of his head made everything even look better. Like, it was, he had the crowd behind him. Like, it was such a strong, powerful match. It looked like a lot of fun just to even be in that audience. Sammy was so gracious too. Even when he came out after Jey Uso found him outside and he's staring up and he's, yeah, this is the very first place I ever wrestled like this when I was here. And now I'm going to come in the same way that I came in the first time through the front doors. And he goes in through the front doors and he's walking around concessions. People are losing their minds. He's going through the crowd. He gets to the ring and or on the inside of the ramp, or not the ramp, the like over by the ring bell and the announcer's table.
Well, the camera work was great.
They followed him the whole time. And then he jumped back out and ran back into the crowd because he wasn't done yet. I'm like, holy shit. How does this crowd not fall in love with Sammy? So it's like he's really got that audience down pat, especially in Canada. But I don't know, man. Like, there's so much to be built up from this. I kind of agree with you. Like, even the moves that Chad was using against Sammy, up until the very last, the ankle lock that he was doing from the top rope, which was a hell of a visual. It was a beautiful visual.
Right. But it looked kind of silly.
Right.
In a way.
Yeah. Right. Yeah, like, there should have been more to it. Like, maybe he should have used a weapon. And I mean, this is all just nitpicky stuff because I don't know how deep this goes, but I just give us more. Give me more. Give Chad a reason to be evil. Give Chad a real villain story where it's, you know, Sammy held me back. Sammy was with me. Something. Give me some kind of bullshit story that makes me believe that Chad should be killing Sammy right now. And if it's going to be something as simple as jealousy, Kev, go full tilt with it. Make him psychotically jealous about Sammy, you know?
Well, now I wonder what happens to Alpha Academy, because, you know, they're a goofball group. I mean, Otis is a goofball. Maxine is a goofball, whether she wants to be or not. And Tozawa is a goofball. So I don't see them turning heel, even though sometimes I'm thinking the only way to save a Maxine is to make her a bad
Otis girl. Was okay as a heel. Nemeth saying Otis is a terrible heel.
He was, but they've gotten, like, they're going to have to change on a dime because of Chad's thing with Sam. If anything, maybe you guys think the same thing. Maybe you think the same thing, Mish. What I'm seeing in next week is Otis and them being very disappointed in Chad for acting like that.
Right.
And telling him, Sammy's our friend. What are you doing? And then him turning on them in a way, the way AJ Styles turned on the OC.
Yeah.
But can they do that with two guys? Would they do that with Chad too, where it becomes a lone wolf like AJ Styles? Isn't that kind of aping what AJ Styles did? Because he turned on his trio.
Right.
Didn't he punch Mishin in the face? Yeah. Didn't he punch Mishin? I believe he knocked her out.
Oh my God.
From what I remember. But yeah, I think it's going to be Otis and them confronting Chad, saying, why'd you do that? You know, I thought we had, you know, dignity and honor in this group, and we're teaching Maxine and Tozawa to be sportsmen. And then AJ, well, you know, what's Chad going to do? Smack Otis? I'm like, this is very AJ Styles OC reminiscent. So, and I would think that they would have a little more originality for that. You know, again, you already have AJ Styles being Lone Wolf McQuaid. But, or maybe Chad, could they do a thing where he feigns he's sorry and still tries to be a babyface?
Oh, like the Chelsea thing?
Yeah, feigns like, I lost it. I just lost it. I'm so frustrated. I can't, you know, I couldn't wait. You know, I had that match. I didn't mean to do that. I just lost my head. Maybe something like that. Because, yeah, for him to go, yeah, you know, you don't like it, you all can go to hell. I'm like, that's too much like what AJ Styles.
Let me ask you this. Dirty Bird even brings it up. He's like, give him the Creed Brothers as a stable, and we saw them on Monday. Obviously, he was training with them.
That could be something, and a heel trio, because Creed Brothers need to go bad too, by the way.
Yeah, they need something too. But do you want Chad solo, or do you want Chad with another stable? Like, you're just hot-shotting.
Stable, because he's a small guy. I mean, AJ too is not the biggest statue West guy, but AJ is a proven commodity, former several time world champion. Chad Gable's still trying to get to the dance.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Right. So Chad Gable's still no gold, you know, he's not wearing any solo gold at all. So AJ Styles has the props, but with Chad, again, he needs something else. And eventually, Sammy's not going to drop the belt right away, but I would think the end goal is to have Chad Gable win this title by even nefarious means, maybe by the Creed Brothers jumping Sami Zayne or something. I like that. Was that Dirty Birdie? But the Creed Brothers being involved would be perfect, actually. And then Otis is charismatic enough to lead the Alpha Academy on his own.
Yes, he is.
Like, let Otis be the new guy in charge.
Otis is another guy who's very versatile. Yeah. And I, even though we saw, you know, people in the chat even saying that he was a terrible heel, when he was playing the silent but deadly heel, where he wasn't talking too much and he would just sit there and have this shit-eating face, you know, like, he was good. He was good as a heel. He was savage. It worked for him. And then, of course, the ladies' man Otis. People can't forget his time with Mandy Rose. Yeah. And then, of course, you have, like, lovable, happy Otis that was trying to be the good guy. And then there was even the model Otis when Maxine and the Maximum Models were trying to get Otis to be the next, I guess, model member or whatever. Like, he's very versatile for being a guy who most people look at him and go, oh, look at that fat fuck. No, he's actually pretty versatile. He's a great guy to have as a henchman. He's a great number two. But yeah, that would be interesting if Otis becomes the leader of the Academy, you know, because I don't think we've ever seen him in a role where he wasn't playing second to Chad.
Well, know? It's funny. Nemeth fan in the chat is saying that Maxine has tried. And I saw Maxine and obviously in that tag match the other day with Ivy Nile. I didn't realize how small Ivy Nile was.
Oh, she's tiny.
Maxine.
Yeah.
My God. And Maxine did the perfect plex. Did you guys see that? She did the perfect plex and did a couple of good moves. But when she tried to sell, she looked like a stumbling giraffe, you know, just flopping around like a fish.
Right.
On the thing. So she pulled some moves. She did a suplex, did a perfect plex. I'm like, okay, she's trying to show us she's learning in the RPC. But then when she tried to sell, she just stumbled and fumbled. I'm like, listen, she's trying. I get it. I don't want to focus on this and Maxine, but I'm just saying. After that perfect plex and she took a kick to the face, she fell so weird and awkwardly. I go, well, that just negated the perfect plex.
Right.
You know, she just lost her footing and fell to the side. I'm like, oh, good Lord.
I do agree, though. I do think she does need to go back to NXT. She does need kind of if the draft happens and she ends up with NXT, I wouldn't be surprised. I'd kind of be for it.
Follow Wrestling Soup on Twitter at Wrestling Soup. Like and subscribe to Wrestling Soup on YouTube. And check out the Discord for live chat during the shows at discord.gg/wrestlingsoup. Check out and subscribe to the shows on Apple, Amazon, iHeartRadio, Spotify,
and more.